your newspaper ad days before.
Nearby.
It's a beautiful day here in the park. Maybe we should have gone to the park.
Yeah. No.
Oh.
I have allergies. But still, you
couldn't ask for a more beautiful,
wonderful, pretty day today.
Would you like to go for a walk around the lake, flower garden?
Want to go to a movie?
Maybe in a minute.
I'd like to sit here for a little while. Can we talk first?
Okay.
So, I understand you work in healthcare?
The music industry.
I am so lonely.
I'm a home health aide for the elderly.
Yes, I'm writing a book on jazz.
That is wonderful. Please help me.
What do you do?
How can I help you?
Oh, I'm just an office manager for a small office.
I'm a computer consultant. Just be real with me.
But I really want to.
Be really, 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 really real with me.
Work in TV.
Own a farm someday.
Unorchestrate your emotion to my song.
Interesting.
Great.
Well, wait a minute.
I have a friend.
I know someone.
Have you read that book?
Who works in TV?
Who owns a farm?
Think it.
Say it.
Speak it. Now, the interactive guide to kicking your inner child's ass.
She says to us.
He says farming is.
I love that book.
A lot of work.
It's changed my life.
But rewarding.
Yeah.
Definitely.
It changed my life too.
Before I read that book, I used to be so polite all the time. I was into
pseudo-ultra-chino-fake bonding.
Like it says in the book.
Before I read that book, I would have come here today and just had a shallow conversation.
It must be really rewarding to you.
About nothing.
Help the elderly.
Write about jazz.
But because of that book, I feel strong enough to say to you,
help me!
It's so rewarding.
I couldn't begin to tell you.
Jazz is my life.
I will help you. What's wrong?
You see, I'm not really over my last boyfriend.
Some people get depressed and look at the elderly.
He told me he was a home health aide for the elderly.
But I don't. I feel hopeful.
But he only had one patient.
To have lived so long and experienced so much.
His mother.
It's a beautiful thing.
Wow!
Every time I would go over to his house, he would excuse himself every few minutes and go into another room. I just thought he had a ladder problem.
But one day, I heard someone talking. So I asked him, who was that?
No one. You're hearing things. I live alone.
But one day, I tiptoed behind him and peeked in the room. There was this old woman sitting in a chair. He was calling her
Mama?
I was very understanding. Oh, honey, is this your mother? You take care of her? It's nothing to be ashamed of. It's sweet. Your mother and all the others, too. Then, this woman, who was, like, so wrinkled, a prune would stare in awe, says,
who are you? Who are you? I'm his one and only patient. His one and only. Get out! I'm the only one who gets their feet shaved around here! You're stepping on my toenail clippings! Get out! Get out!
2 days later, he was like,
I tried to be a home health care worker, but Mama takes up all of my time. I love Mama. I love Mama. I love Mama. I do. Before that, she and Mima took up all of my time. I love Mima. I love Mima. I love Mima. I do. But Mima's dead now. And Mama will be too. And then you can move into my house. We'll have kids. 2 boys, 2 girls. We'll teach you to be good little home health care workers. Because, like Mama always says, by the time we grow old, our social security checks won't buy us a cup of milk.
You are so noble.
But I still think of him.
I know what you mean. I'm still hung up over my last girlfriend, too. She wanted to be a farmer.
I know it's a lot of work. But to be out in the fresh country air.
A chicken farmer.
Communing with nature every day. Feeding the land, feeding the chickens.
But that's not all she wanted to do with those chickens.
What's wrong with you?
I've got hang up my butt!
That is the last time you go to a farm.
What? No!
Yes, it is!
But farming is my life!
But you don't own a farm! How come every time you have to go and make love? We sneak into some other person's barn. It was exciting, but now it's just weird.
You're so conventional.
I am not. What was that?
Nothing.
It sounded like I opened the closet door and there are all these chickens. Chickens everywhere. What the?
Don't touch them. I love them. See how soft and gentle.
You can't keep chickens in the apartment.
Quiet. Don't yell in front of them. See, they're so sweet and gentle. Like kittens. Kittens with feathers. But sexy. Very sexy.
We see ourselves.
I studied everything I could about jazz just to get close to him. I bought thousands of CDs. One day, I bought him this Miles Davis CD. It took me 6 months to find it. I was going to surprise him and put it with his collection, but I must have hit some secret door or something, because, honey?
Yeah, baby?
I wanted to give you this.
Oh, Miles Davis session number 73, thank you!
Yeah, I was going to surprise you and slip it in with the others.
Uh-huh, this is perfect, baby. Thank you so much.
And I found this.
Oh. Yeah. I was holding on to that for my mother. My mother.
A Yanni CD? No, you weren't. Yanni, John Tesh, Enya, Celine Dion, Phil Collins, what is this about? I thought you were cool.
Hey, watch it! You're gonna scratch him. One night, I couldn't sleep, alright, so I turned on the radio. They were playing Desert Siren by Yanni. It was so relaxing, so calm. Yanni is beautiful. Someday, he'll be appreciated. Someday.
I want you to teach me everything you know about music.
John Tesh, you.
So, you see, it must be.
No. Don't assume that. Once I dated this girl.
I know TV is supposed to be this vast wasteland.
Who wanted to work in TV?
But I think it's a powerful and effective medium.
So she watched a lot of TV.
To communicate and express ideas.
But then I noticed she'd only watch one program.
We're on our way up to the east side.
Honey, do we have to? But you've seen this episode 100 times already.
All day and night in the Jeffersons. She would tape it and watch it in fast forward and reverse.
See? Right there.
What?
Lyle just said, pop tattoo burst on my...
What?
He said, pop tattoo burst on my...
What are you saying?
You see, I have a little language for Lyle. I speak his lines backwards because I think he's giving us a message so we can understand.
Giving you a message.
Yes, us a message to the world. Did you know that Lionel created the show Good Times?
Honey.
And the man that replaced him was his brother, his very own brother?
Honey, I...
But he's gone now. No word of him since 1979, but I will find him. I know I will, I know. Pop tattoo burst on my, pop tattoo burst on my, pop tattoo burst on my.
I have never thought of TV that way before.
I'll never watch The Jeffersons again, in honor of you.
Listen, I have to tell you, I really like you.
You're wonderful.
Terrific. You touched my inner song, and let me tell you, baby, it ain't playing Yanni.
Well, I think you're great.
My inner song, too.
I would love to. Get to know you. Spend some more time with you.
Coordinate your soul with mine.
Ah, great.
But first I have to
stop at home for a minute.
Stop by the record store.
My afternoon is completely free.
Oh, I suppose you have to check on your patients.
Are you buying the latest jazz CD?
Yeah.
Well, that works out, because I have to set my VCR to record a program.
Stop by this new chicken farm. My afternoon is free, too.
So, see you later, then?
See you later, then.
Great!
But
Well, I can't believe you are
available. Not married.
Unattached.
There are just too many crazy people out there. I'm telling you.
You got that right.
Tell me about it.
I can tell you stories.
My last boyfriend.
Girlfriend?
Was a pathological liar. Really?
No kidding.
What are the chances of that?
It really is a small world.